In this video today, I'm going to be setting up my version of a lap pulley setup, a laparoscopic cholecystectomy. Let's start off in the beginning here. I already got my Mayo stand draped out. But other than that, we're going to be starting from the beginning. So it starts off the same, just breaking down my path. Organize all my instruments. Lap pulleys, we would normally count on lap pulleys at the beginning, and if it stayed laparoscopic, we wouldn't count at the end. Get all my countable stuff on my Mayo stand, all my soft stuff, and get it ready to count. I'm gonna get all my instruments organized and ready to count. Same way every time you set up a lap set like this, you're gonna put your bottom in this order, right here, the bottom of your tray. So go Harrington, wide deaver, medium deaver, narrow deaver, a large ridge, medium ridge, small ridge, two malleables, pole suction, and two Army Navies. So at this point, I have all my stuff organized, ready to count. I would count. But we're gonna cover that in another video on how to count lap set instruments and how to count soft stuff properly. So for this video, I'm just going to skip that and I'm going to go ahead and keep setting up. Your Mayo stand's going to get set up mostly like it does on your minor setup, with a few small changes. So whenever I set up my lap pulleys, the main thing that really changes is I kind of shift everything over to this side of my Mayo stand close to me, and I have all my laparoscopic stuff on the other side of the Mayo stand. Towel roll for my Mayo stand. Your instruments are going to vary from surgeon to surgeon and what kind of instruments you put up. So So for the most part, I'm going to try and get you to put up everything that will cover all the surgeons here at our hospital. So I'm going to do 4 hemostats, 3 peons, 1 tonsil, 1 long peon, 2 ellis, 2 Ochsner's, 2 Crowwoods and 2 Mayo Hagar needle drivers. Like I said, this is probably way too much for any one surgeon, but this covers all of our surgeons. And also 2 towels. Put all the rest of my scissors that I'm not going to use back on my rack. Now I'm going to organize my endoscopic instruments, my laparoscopic instruments. And I'm just going to go through and close all the caps on these. Normally these come assembled, so we won't have to do that, but I'll show you how to do it here anyways. Open the jaws up all the way. You're going to slide the instrument that you want in there. You're going to line up these holes right here. And you're just going to squeeze the ratchets down until it clicks. I'm going to check it, so see it didn't seat all the way in there. Try it again, and then you get that click, and then make sure it works. And you'll just do that to all of your instruments. These are ratcheting graspers, is what we call them, because they have the ratcheting handles here. It's got a little bit longer of a jaw on it. Different. You have to push the button down right here. Kind of got to watch your glove when you do that. Same thing, put this end here, it slides in, push all the way down, and just as you close it, it should click in like that and make sure it works. These are your 2 main different graspers here. Like I said, we have the ratcheting grasper. It has longer jaws on it right here. Right? So you can grab it and hold it and not really have to keep squeezing down. And then you have just a regular grasper here with this one. A little bit shorter jaws. And that's just surgeon preference between these two. And you always have 2 of them. The other thing you're going to need is your dissectors. We have a couple different ones of those. These are your 2 main different graspers that we have. We have a Maryland right here, and this is what we would call our blunt Maryland. We also have a finer tipped one in there. And then you have a fenestrated grasper. It's got the little slot in here, or a slotted dissector, sometimes it's called. So those are our 2 different types of dissectors that we mainly use. And it's just gonna be surgeon preference on that also. Next, I have a biopsy forceps in here. It's got a little tooth in there. You need to take a biopsy of something. We have a spoon grasper, so whenever we spill stones inside the abdomen, this scoops up the stones. We have a large tooth grasper. Some doctors call that the mother-in-law. And we have various types of suction in here, a 10 millimeter, 5 millimeter suction, and that's all these two do is suction out fluid. And we also have suction irrigator that has a Bobby attachment with it. And the two different ones we have in that is either a spatula or a hook. Most surgeons here are going to use the hook. So you're going to take the sleeve for it, and that covers all this metal right here. Otherwise, any metal touching skin would burn it. So this is a protective sleeve. Slides over it, click it on. When you hand it to the surgeon, it should be protected, the tip, and they can suction with that. And when they're ready to Bobby, they just slide the tip back. Then we have our scissors here. I don't have a scissor tip with me, but other than that, we're just going to organize the bottom of our tray here. Probably going to look neater than this, but right. For this demonstration, I'm going to use our ratcheting graspers and the Marilyn. You can place these up here on the mechanism. I'm just going to kind of organize the rest of this stuff so I can get to it if I need to get to it. I'm going to put this is a clip applier. This is what we're going to put our clips on the cystic duct and cystic artery right here. Okay. Typically when it comes out of the package, the 10 millimeter one doesn't have a clip loaded, so you have to preload it. You just squeeze your handle and let go, and there's one in there. I paired that up with my scissors. You're going to need both of those together at the same time. Moving up here, this is our insufflation tubing here, right? So we're going to fill CO2 up in the abdomen. Going to set that down there. I'm going to go and get the rest of the stuff out here. We got our suction irrigator here. Sometimes I'll put this up on my Mayo stand, but it kind of starts to get a little crowded, so occasionally I'll just leave it back here on my back table also. You know, light handles up here. We have all of our different types of trocars here. The two main trocars that you're going to see are a blunt trocar, or that's also called an OptiView trocar. You can insert the camera in this end. You wanted to. It's blunt on the end, there's no sharp ends. You just have these little wings on here, and this trocar is kind of meant to be turned as it goes in. This trocar here has a blade inside of it. So we activate the blade by pushing that down. And you can see as this pulls back, the blade actually comes out of there. Okay, so we want to make sure that's activated when we give it to the surgeon. We want to make sure all of our stopcocks are closed. And here we have a varus needle. It's one method of getting into the abdomen. And depending on the order that the surgeon puts these in the abdomen, I just kind of flip-flop them back and forth and just save space sitting like that. So they're flat on the front. And again, that's going to be surgeon preference on what you use. Your camera and your light cord in here, they come kind of wound up in here a lot bigger than I put them up on there. It's a lot easier if you just make smaller loops. You don't want to make them too small because you don't want to damage any of the cords inside. makes it easier to handle like this. Same thing with our life board. Don't want to make too tight of curves on there and break the fibers inside. And this is usually, I always try to pass this off in the same order. There's really only one surgeon here that cares what order it goes off in. So I just put it in that same order all the time. It's convenient. And the easy way to remember it is lights, camera, and then it's ablations action. So lights, camera, action. Sorry. So show you the difference between a 0 degree scope and a 30 degree scope. You notice this 30 degree scope has this, that's it, 30 degrees right there. So when we're inside the abdomen, if we need to look over the top of something and look down further, that kind of gives you a better view. And your scopes are just going to be surgeon preference. It's going to vary from surgeon to surgeon. I think that's pretty much basic setup for lap pulling.